Vishnu has preserved and Shiva has destroyed. So there are three gods. But still we have a confusion that there is a Advaitic says there is no difference between Atma and Paramatma.
Yes, I think it's a very, very profound question. And you have actually predicted my next session already. Because in the next session, we are going to discuss all this, these three forces of creation, maintenance, and destruction, and also the Jeev and Paramatma, that is Brahm and Jeev. What is the difference between individual soul and the Brahm? So we will discuss that in a great detail, but yes, on the ultimate analysis, if you go to the final analysis, everything is interconnected in harmonious way. There is complete Advait in the ultimate analysis. But for our understanding, we have to pass through various ingredients. Like a doctor examines various organs of your body when you fall sick. But ultimately, all those organs are integrated into a system. And how they are integrated, it's not easy to understand even for the doctors who have spent their lifetime on this system. But we will try to understand that the individual organs and their integration, how it works in the universal scale. So we will deal with this in greater detail tomorrow. But yes, as I am telling you today, that there are two parts. There are forces of creation, there are forces of maintenance, there are forces of destruction. There is individual soul and there is universal soul. But at the ultimate analysis, they are interconnected.
Sir, in the same way, like my second question is, when you say that everything is happening of its own, like nothing is, but let it be the next session, because when you say that it is Shiva who is destructing and Brahma who is creating, so there is definitely a superpower to guide these things.
So, yeah, but firstly I'll tell you, you know, don't think of superpower in terms of human or any sort of image. That is a energy, that is an avyakt force, unmanifested force. You should think in terms of unmanifested force. And we will talk about that unmanifested force. I think we have to go from vyakt to avyakt. And that will be our journey to transcend into a higher realm of life. When you go from avyakt to avyakt, you will realize how enormous difference and power, you know, is there in avyakt. It's unbelievable, unimaginable to think of it right now. But when you transcend, and you will transcend, I'm sure we will all transcend into that with our conversation slowly, into that power of avyakt, into that power of non-manifest. And that will enable us to understand the harmony of this universe. Yes.
Like, sir,
even if
you say COVID also, in the COVID, which is like a disaster happened in the world, which is, it is not happen of its own, like it is doesn't say, you can say it evolves of its own. Something, a very big force which is working on this. The virus was existing in somebody's, some animal's body, but it comes and becomes a pandemic. So these are all these also the issues which you can cover in the next time.
Yes, yes. You know, nothing happens without a cause. Remember this basic law of universe. There must be a cause for something to happen. So don't think anything happens on its own. No. Everything happens for a cause. And we talked in our last session of karma that, you know, all the things which we are starting with prarabha and, you know, sanchit karma and destiny, they are not on their own. They have emanated from our own actions in the past. So nothing happens on its own. Everything happens for a reason. There's a cause for that. And that cause we will try to understand how that works. It's at a universal scale. We spoke in the last session on the individual scale. Now we will talk about this on the universal scale.
Beautiful explanation. Next time it will be again more fruitful, discussion, because there are so unanswered questions in my mind, sir. I must say.
Yeah, yeah, we will try to find answer to all of them. I don't promise that we will find, but we will try. Okay.
दक्षिण जी की इजाजत हो तो एक आध हम भी अपनी एक तो ये क्यूरियोसिटी को देख के दिमाग में भी इमीडिएटली तो यह पहले मैं शेयर कर लेता हूँ सागर अभिवादन टू माय स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर किया कि एक तो एलिमेंट्री है कि एडवांस अब इसकी फ्रीक्वेंसी क्लासेस की भी इतने बढ़ जाए तो अच्छा है कुछ लोगों के लाभ के लिए अब ये आपका डिसीजन है आप कर पाएंगे समय दे पाएंगे तो हम लोग अनुग्रहित होंगे नहीं दूसरा प्रभु आपने हमको ये दलदल में फंसा के मैनिफेस्टेशन के और अनमैनिफेस्टेड के में अब हमसे कहते हो कि आप सवाल पूछो तो हमारे पास सवाल ही कि दलदल से बाहर निकालो ये सब जो जगत और संसार और ये माया वाला जो चक्कर है इससे बाहर निकलने के लिए अब जहाँ तक हम समझ पाए हैं कि ब्रह्म साकार ब्रह्म निराकार ब्रह्म कंट्रोवर्सीज टू साइड्स ऑफ कॉइन्स ये सारी चीजें चलती चली आई हैं आदिकाल से अनंतकाल और अल्टीमेटली अगर कहीं कन्वर्ज हो पाई है टू माय बेस्ट ऑफ माय नॉलेज एंड बिलीव तब तो मसीह के ऊपर जैसे हम गॉड की बात करते हैं तो भगवान शब्द हिंदी में हम उसको ट्रांसलेट कर लेते हैं अब भगवान की जो उत्पत्ति है नेचुरोपैथी के हिसाब से और शास्त्रों में भी कहीं विदित होगा वो पांच तत्व से मिलके बना है भा भूमि गा गगन वा वायु वा में आ अग्नि और ना नीर तो अब जो आकाश तत्व है सबसे ज्यादा तरल है तो तत्वमसी मतलब उससे भी ज्यादा जो तरल हो सकता है विच इज अनमैनिफेस्टेड तो वो शायद वो सिचुएशन है जो कि हम सेंस नहीं कर सकते केवल अनुभूति के कारण और गोस्वामी तुलसीदास जी ने तो इतनी अध्ययन करके लिख दिया कि वही जानत जिन देव जनाई और जानत तुम्हें तुम्हें हो जाई श्री कृष्ण जी ने श्रीमद भागवत गीता में भी विराट रूप जो दिखाया है वो दिव्य चक्षु देने के बाद ही दिखाया है यानी जिसकी पात्रता शिष्य की होगी उसको ही वो अनुभूति हो सकती है उसी को दर्शन हो सकते हैं तो ये सारी चीजें अगर हम किसी ज्ञानी तपस्वी के एक हमको कपलेट याद आ रहा है कि मुझी को देख ले वो तेरे चाहने वाले यानी गॉड को मुझी को देख ले वो तेरे चाहने वाले तू आयना है मेरा मैं तेरा आयना हूं और किसी ने तो और आगे कह दिया खुदा के बारे में गॉड के बारे में कि खुदा ही मोहब्बत है मोहब्बत ही खुदा तो अगर उसको समझना है उसको जानना है तो ना से मोहब्बत कर और मोहब्बत के अनुसार जो आप आई गो बैक टू योर टीचिंग्स इन वन ऑफ द सेशन कि लेवल ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस हम अपने दायरों को जितना बढ़ा लेंगे उतना व्यापक कर लेंगे हमारी चेतना का जितना विकास हो जाएगा हमारी ये जिज्ञासाएं उतनी जल्दी शांत होती चली जाएंगी और हम उसी मर्जर वाली पोजिशन में आ जाएंगे दिस इज वॉट आई हैव अंडरस्टूड सो फार प्लीज एड समथिंग ऑन टू इट for my benefit and for the benefit of the Badan those who are involved. Thank you very much, sir.
First of all, Kuldeep ji, ye sansar daldal nahi hai. Aapko is sansar mein daldal nazar kyon aa raha hai? Ye sansar to pura Paramatma hi hai. Ye Brahma ki hi, wo hai, vistar hai. Brahma ka matlab kya hota
hai? Sir, ye kahi suni baatein hai sari, jo likhi hui hai. Brahma satyam jagat mithya. जीव है ब्रह्म शंकराचार्य का उदाहरण दिया था
नहीं 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 कोई
तो ये सब अलग अलग लोगों ने अलग अलग बात कही ग्रेट कंफ्यूजन इसीलिए दलदल है और दलदल से निकालने वाले को ही गुरु कहते हैं तो हम आपसे चाहते हैं कि हमको दलदल से निकालें ये इस चक्कर में नहीं फंसाए मैनिफेस्टेड और अनमैनिफेस्टेड में नहीं तो एलिमेंट्री क्लास और एडवांस क्लास दो कर लें क्षमा करें कुछ ज्यादा कह
कोई दिक्कत नहीं है उसमें ऐसा है कि नॉलेज एक ही है वो कहते हैं ना कि नॉलेज को अलग अलग लोगों ने अलग अलग शब्दों में कहा है
जी इंटरप्रिटेशन
वो फर्क नहीं पड़ता देखिए जब हम ये मान लें कि पूरी सृष्टि ही ब्रह्मा का स्वरूप है तो दलदल का तो कोई प्रश्न ही पैदा नहीं होता आप देखिए कि भगवान कृष्ण की लाइफ जिनको हम पूर्णावतार कहते हैं उनकी लाइफ में सब कुछ था उनके लाइफ में तो पूरा संसार था और वो संसार से विरक्त थे कम्प्लीटली तो वो स्थिति हमें आनी चाहिए कि हम संसार में रहते हुए संसार से विरक्त हो जाएं वो चीज आनी चाहिए, यहाँ से भग के हिमालय में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है, न किसी आश्रम में जाके बैठने की जरूरत है। आप संसार में रहिए, संसार के जितने भी आपके कार्य आप करते रहिए, और उसके साथ साथ इस संसार से डिटैच होके आप विरक्त हो जाए। आई थिंक दैट इज द ओनली वे वी कैन मूव फॉरवर्ड, एंड वी विल टॉक अबाउट दिस इन द नेक्स्ट,
यही मार्ग है।
मे बी इन द नेक्स्ट टू सेशंस वी विल टॉक, फर्स्ट वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस वर्ल्ड बेटर, यू नो ऑल द फोर्सेज एंड द इश्यूज व्हिच वर जस्ट डिस्कस्ड, आत्मा क्या है, परमात्मा क्या है, ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश क्या है, ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, एंड देन वी विल ट्राई टू मूव फ्रॉम मैनिफेस्ट टू नॉन मैनिफेस्ट और व्यक्त टू अव्यक्त। सो आई थिंक वी विल मूव इन दैट डायरेक्शन, एंड वी नीड नॉट टू गेट कन्फ्यूज ऑन एनी थिंग। ऑल द थिंग्स विच हैव बीन सेड बाय द वाइज पीपल, दे आर ऑल इन देयर कॉन्टेक्स्ट राइट, दे हैव सेड दैट इन अ पर्टिकुलर कॉन्टेक्स्ट, so we don't have to pick it up out of context, cause it independently, then it causes confusion, you see, we have to take it in the context it has been said।
एक आध रेफरेंस बुक दे दीजिए बैकग्राउंड पेपर की तरह, जिसको के हम लोग पढ़ लें और कुछ बेसिक चीजों पर पहुंच जाएं, तो आगे की बात
आप समझ। या we will do that, okay, so any more questions?
मेरे ख्याल में सर अव्यक्त अव्यक्त जो आप में बोल रहे हैं वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, बिकॉज देर आर सो मेनी अनएक्सप्लेनेबल इश्यूज हैज टू बी कैप्ट एज इट इज, बिकॉज दे विल ऑलवेज बी एन अनआंसर्ड।
या दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज अव्यक्त एंड हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट अव्यक्त, दैट यू नो यू कैन नॉट understand that avyakt with your sense organs, because sense organs are not the tools designed for that। जैसे आँखों से आप सुन नहीं सकते, आँखों से देख ही सकते हैं, यही है ना, इसी तरह से इन पांचों सेंस ऑर्गन्स को मिला के आप उस अव्यक्त के फील्ड में नहीं जा सकते। अव्यक्त को समझने के लिए एक नई प्रणाली हमको सोचनी पड़ेगी और उसका हम डिस्कस करेंगे, दैट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन इन वेरियस राइटिंग्स इन द पास्ट, एंड वी विल गो थ्रू दैट प्रोसेस, and I'm sure we will make sure that we all understand that properly। Dinesh
Gauri, there are people in this world who don't believe in God at all, they just don't believe the God at all।
Yeah, but that is what I started with।
No,
I started
you have
with
given your four points, but they say all these four points are physical, there is nothing which like is God.
They are better
than
us.
That is what I started with that this whole thing is a collection of matter, that is what my beginning of this talk was, these people believe that this whole universe is a collection of matter, it has been put together on its own, they just accidentally it happened and the life was formed accident, that is what their belief is, that is what Charvak also said in Indian philosophy, we have Charvak who is very very famous in our own philosophy, not only the West but our own people, so there are people who believe in that, but the same people talk about order, talk about harmony, they talk about you cannot behave like this, you cannot walk on the left side of the road, you should walk only on the right hand side, I'm talking about Canada, so you see the same people talk about an order ki aap apna ghar yahan nahi banao, yahi banao, ye nali yahan se nikalni chahiye, aapka behavior aisa hona chahiye, why they talk of order then, if they believe in accident, that whole universe has come out accidentally, why are they talking about order, because your conscience does not accept that anarchy, your conscience believe that there is an order।
I have traveled in China a lot, in China, believe me, nobody believes in God in China even, and
yeah, but Chinese are communist, they communist people don't believe in God,
my dear friend,
sir, I would say they believe in Buddhist, and Buddhist say there is no God, you see, you are like यू हैव टू बिकम योर ओन गॉड, व्हाट बुद्धा सेज, आपो दीपो भव. सो दैट इज ओके, दैट इज ओके. इफ समबडी सेज देयर इज नो गॉड, व्हाट्स रॉन्ग इन इट? व्हाट्स रॉन्ग?
या एग्जैक्टली.
कोरोना पैदा होता है दिनेश भाई मां.
Yeah, no, let everybody has his own belief. Let us leave that. Let everybody has his own belief. You have your own belief.
Correct.
You don't have to believe in God. Okay? But you see the order in front of you. Everything works in an order. And we will talk about that in more detail tomorrow. And then you will feel that there is an order. Now, what is that order? You can call it God and you may not call it God. Doesn't matter. For me, it doesn't matter. But for me, that order, that harmony, that cycle, that flow, which is there in this universe, is that God. That is what has been defined as God by us, by humans. Because we want to find an answer. God has not come here and told you that I am God. Nobody has done that. Okay? It is we who have created him.
Will you permit me to
one second.
Say a small observation?
I come to the second aspect of God. For different people, the God is different. I mean, the God in India itself, the God has so many different versions and so many different forms and so many different understandings that it's unbelievable.
No, not so many. Every individual has a different God. So there are as many gods as there are individuals. And some people actually believe in more than one. So you can multiply that 7.4 billion into, you know, many.
That is
the number of gods, okay? So don't worry about that.
So your second and third...
Don't worry about the multiplication.
We are looking forward to your second and third sessions, which will have something to do with realization.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, we will do that. We will do that. I will structure that second session and third session in a way that we come closer to realization of abhyakt. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay, so now, any more question?
Sir, one observation, if you permit me, Shwami. You were defining about an order. Order has been established already for grahast also. Or panch order defined ke gaya shastra, which we practice. Most of our generations, we have practiced. But now we have forgotten. One is the first yagna is the pitra yagna. Then Bhut Vanaspati Yajna. Then Bhut Vanaspati Yajna. I will forget one. And Dev Yajna and Dham Yajna. These five orders have been defined in daily acts for human beings to conserve the harmony between the nature and the beings. And for
well-being. Don't limit these orders to five or one or two. You know, we will talk in a separate session afterwards in the concept of dharma. The dharma will explain you what order means and what it means. And
that
then
would be
it will be very clear what would be our, order, or what is the order which governs this whole universe. Because the dharma is a very, very profound concept. We'll talk about it after we finish this thing. I have something else in mind before that. We will talk about Sukh and Dukh after we finish this series on the goal. We'll talk about Sukh and Dukh and then we'll talk about Dharma. So we will go in that order. So don't confine two orders to one or two or five. There could be many more and multiple.